On Friday, a recording of us was played into the house upon Jade's eviction. Such remarks as "she's not that fit," "loser," and "get out" were branded around the house for everyone to hear.
We are sorry for the offence we caused to the housemates' families, and in particular the evictee.
We recorded many versions of eviction countdowns that day. Never in our wildest dreams did we think this version would be used.
Please accept our sincerest regrets, and we promise not to do it again if we can help it.
Thank you.
Pair of pricks! I don't care! You're fat, you're ugly. It's Big Brother's big mouth.
Nice one, come on, get sorted.
Anybody got any mirrors?
Lovely. I'm Matt Horn.
And I'm James Corden.
Joining us tonight, could she be the most beautiful homeless girl in the world? It's Jade.
Yeah! Yeah! And we've got the co-founder of Viz, who's about to succeed Sam Allardyce at Newcastle United, is Simon Donald.
Yeah! And my mates, Cardiff City's notorious soul crew, the studio audience. We'll be talking to that lot a little later, but first, there was a chilling moment in the Big Brother house. For a moment, we thought Myra Hindley was the hijacker.
That's not me, it's a great.
Oh, my God, I'm so glad I didn't go.
Oh, me too, wow.
It's not. Before you get all, you know, it's just Amelia in a wig, and it's not a good look.
Now, as we know, we're dealing with some exceptionally gifted young adults in there. General knowledge, though, not really Amelia's strong point. Have a look at this.
What Geldof daughter?
Who's Bob Geldof?
We're doing it, but we're doing... What do you mean, who is Bob Geldof?
Did you not hear me? Did you not hear me when they were talking?
The guy who organised Live Aid.
Who's Bob Geldof? It's a good job you can put your ass on your head, love.
I mean, who doesn't know who Peaches Geldof's dad is?
Now, I don't like Mondays. Who does? Or January. So don't just sit there thinking of ways to end it all. Use your computer or phone to tell us your thoughts on Big Brother. And you can download the podcast we recorded the other day, and it features Jade.
Phone us, text us, or email us your thoughts, feelings and messages via the website.
The world of hip-hop and R&B music is awash with bold claims, from LL Cool J's Greatest of All Time to R. Kelly's I Don't See Nothing Wrong with a Little Bump and Grind. It makes Nathan's 2005 hit, Come Into My Room, seem like a modest request, but it's one that a couple of ladies seem to be taking quite seriously. Watch this CCTV evidence.
Wow.
Nathan is a top guy.
One of the nicest people I've ever met. Coming out of
my cage, you know. Karate!
I have four goals. To meet new people, to have fun, to expose what I do,
the way that you want me to live,
and to win.
I love you guys.
So does everyone think LaToya likes me?
I think she wants a bit for Nathan.
I really like LaToya in a friend way. I don't want to feel like I'm leading anyone on.
My God!
You bitch!
Amy is my favourite, though. Sorry, guys.
He's using me to make you jealous.
If God asks me what I like, I say Amy.
Who do you fancy in the house?
Amy.
I can't believe he said that.
More than LaToya?
Yeah.
I think you're too good for LaToya personally, but that's...
He's joking, though, babe.
Yeah, obviously.
Are you single?
Almost.
Player.
No, I'm single.
I can't look at him, it's too embarrassing.
So there he is. We decided to call this discussion United Nathans or a Nathan in Turmoil. Essentially, we're asking Nathan or Yathan, it's time to have a nay. I mean, it's just getting... For fuck's sake. What's that? God. Hi, Jade.
Hi,
how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. I'm all right. How have a few days been since you've been out of the house?
Really good.
What
really
have you
fun.
Been?
Climbing, catching up with family and friends. I did BBLB yesterday, I'm here today. I've got a few like photo stuff coming up this week. And yeah, just stuff like that.
Go, Jade! Exciting. Come on!
What's it like? Watching a house there and not being in it, how does it feel?
It was a bit weird to start with. Like, actually, the first day I came out, I know I was only in like a week, but it felt like a month, if that makes sense.
It felt like a year. I've only been in a week. I feel like I'm living.
There you go. So it was a bit strange looking like back, and I kept, every time I got out of bed and I expected to see like lights and music to wake me up.
Sure.
And I kept looking for my microphone and stuff. But
so we're talking about Nathan. Uh-huh. Is he a player? What's he up to?
I don't know. He's just a big flirt, I think. I don't think he really likes anyone in there. I think he's just a big flirt.
Uh-huh. Simon, lovely to have you here.
Thank you very much.
I know that you came in especially to discuss whether Nathan's a player. You made that clear
is
to
that
the researchers.
Right? I have a confession to make.
Go on.
I only have terrestrial television and I don't watch this programme.
Well,
that is actually a lie. But right. I thought it might be quite useful in this situation because I watched about half an hour of this earlier on.
Okay.
And that felt like an eternity to me. And I can't quite tell you yet who Nathan is. I think
he's
right
behind you. That's Nathan there. And the VT we just
and
ran.
What are the questions?
Well, the question I just ask is Nathan, player,
player,
what's he up to?
What
my hunch is you can't answer. What do they think?
He could only go on appearances.
These people
really.
Are all Nazis!
Yeah. Only joking. I just thought that I had to make a big presence, you know.
Yeah.
Make a big statement. They said, say what you want to say.
Yeah, right, Donald. Chill.
You
what
eat too
think
many
of Nathan?
Pies.
What do you think of Nathan? We've got to achieve up here.
You eat too. Oh, I'm not supposed to be talking about you.
What?
I'm not supposed to be talking about him. I'm trying to make it fun.
Simon.
Anyway, I'm going to start a campaign to get
him. Right, here we go. So,
Jim, we've got a chief here who wants to talk about Nathan. What do you think of Nathan?
I don't think nothing of him at all. He's not got nothing to him. He takes about 10 minutes to make his point, and even then, he's not got nothing to say for himself.
But he's just come out. He's just come out, and he said that he likes somebody. Does that not spice things up?
He's trying to get himself a bit of attention because he's not got nothing going for him in his music career. So,
let's talk to a Nathan lover. Hands off the sword.
Nathan's cool, right? We need someone like Nathan in the UK R&B industry. I mean, we've only got Lamar, and he's rubbish, to be quite honest.
Is him being in the house, do we think, threatening his credibility as a recording artist? What do you think?
I think he's a naughty guy, and it should say swinger songwriter there.
Really?
Oh. He's not done anything that bad.
He's not been that bad, is he?
He's got the London massive. He's a London boy. He's our generation. He's wicked. Big up the London massive.
Do we think that he maybe might be trying to play them against each other, the two girls?
No. He's a lovely guy and he's genuine, and I think he is in there to build up his career in singing, which he will do.
Thank you very much. Now, talking of Amy, did anyone think Amy's reaction to the situation was a little bit over the top?
I mean, what's that? It's nothing. The only thing missing from the end of that is like, wow, wow, wow.
She's gone a bit. Everybody seems to love her.
Hijackers and housemates seem to like her.
No way.
What are we saying about Amy, Jake?
She's
I think she's a really nice girl. Uh-huh. Really nice. No, she honestly was a really genuine girl. But at the same time, I kind of feel like she hasn't really done what she wants to. She's kind of just played along to keep everyone happy. I don't think she's kind of
being herself.
I don't know, she's being herself, but she's just trying to keep balance in the house rather than doing what she wants to do.
Well, listen, let's find out if Amy is Nathan's type, because we've got Miles, who's Nathan's best mate, on the phone. Hi, Miles,
hey,
how are you?
How you doing? How you doing, people?
Yeah, we're
hey,
good,
Miles.
We're good. So, listen, tell us, how's Nathan getting on there? Are we seeing the real him? Is that your mate in there?
Yeah, definitely. I think when Nathan first went in there, I don't think he knew what to expect. But I think now he's actually got comfortable because he's got to know the people a bit more in there.
Sure.
So he's opening up a lot more. So, yeah, I think he's doing good, man.
Is Amy or LaToya his type?
To be honest, I think that he's seen things in each of the girls. Like, being in there for a week, he's got to know their personalities. I don't think he's attracted to them like that. But I think that, like, he's got to know them pretty well and he thinks that, like, they've got certain qualities that are nice.
Miles, he's talked about some girl on the outside who he has feelings for. Do you know who this person is?
No, Nathan
hasn't
got no one on the outside.
Really? Really? Because he keeps saying he's almost single and stuff like that. I mean...
Yeah, no. But I think because Chris came at him with, like, who do you like, who do you fancy? So I think he had to say that to kind of, you know, ease it down. But, no, Nathan's single, just trying to concentrate on his music, really.
Do you think this will be good for his music career, Miles?
To be honest, I think there's a lot of people out there that know about Nathan's music but don't know who he is. So he's trying to, like, get more exposure so people know about him and know about, like, could actually link his music to faith. So I'm hoping that when he comes out, it can do that.
Great. Cool. Thank you so Miles. Much for calling, Miles. We'll see you soon.
Thanks,
James, is he a good bloke, Nathan? Is he a nice guy in there? Is he, what is he seems quite popular in there.
When I was in there, I thought he was, like, really nice, really generous, always, like, really friendly and stuff. So on coming out and realising that he nominated me, I was like, oh, I thought you really liked me, do you know what I mean? So you don't know, but at the same time, you have to nominate someone, don't you? So.
Great.
Thanks, Jade. Now, don't be an Alexander Graham Bellend. Get in touch with us using your telephone and your voice could feature on this feature.
Now, in honour of Jade being here as our guest, during the mouthpiece, we're going to have our very own beauty pageant. Miss or Mr. Big Brothers Big Mouth 2008. Jade, you've approximately 1 minute to judge every member of the studio audience on their wit and beauty.
Coming out of the Big Brother house can be a busy time. For example, it's been suggested that the 2000 film Miss Congeniality is a documentary covering Jade's first 24 hours out of the house. Here's the mouthpiece and a synopsis of that extraordinary film.
I've just got one thing to say to Andy McDowd. You're a fucking bastard. What a freak show. Jay looks like Nosferatu. Jeremy's got the mark of Satan in the middle of his forehead.
I think Victor is worried that his sister might get off with that singer guy and he won't be able to have a partner to do a circus act with. And I think... That's what I think.
I think since Jade left, it is rubbish. Since Jade left, it was rubbish. Next, I think... sorry, I'll start again. Bye.
I've never seen anybody eat so much as that Amy. Every time I look at her, she's eating. Is that all she does in the Big Brother house? I'm a great fan of Big Brother, me. I watch every single one of them. 24-7, the eyes are glued.
Oh, Victor is very, very sexy. He looks like Robert De Niro, actually. And I like him very, very, very much.
There she
Here's
is,
the winner.
Miss Big Mouth 2008. Sit on your throne. Hey! This is your throne.
Shocked.
And you win this as a prize. There's your little helmet there. And you just get to sit there for the rest of the show. There she is.
Look at her.
Thank you so much, Jade.
Thanks, Jade.
Wow.
Right. It's come to our attention that some of you went on an ad binge over the weekend. We just feel that it's our duty to say that although ads do give you a natural high and a sense of elation, please view them in moderation. It will be a long time before a government review of ads takes place, so please enjoy these ads sensibly. Roll with the calm down.
Bye.
In a hijack situation, should you always comply with the hijacker's demands?
I've been hijacked and I took them around Hyde Park, gave them 80 quid and they gave me their number. They were robbers from the East End.
Psyched up and ready for Ryland is the studio audience.
Now, James and myself went on a double date this weekend with Ross Kemp on Gangs and his brother Hugh Fernley Whittingstall. It was a romantic picnic, but Kemp had been at the bloody Carver all afternoon, and when Fernley Whittingstall cracked open the Scotch eggs, Kemp on Gangs was immediately sick on himself. The topic of conversation then turned to how best to get vomit out of Kashmir. We ummed and we ahed, and Fernley finally declared that one should put it in a barrel of tar and sticks and set fire to it. He then went about proving it. Check this.
If Scotland were to be hijacked, how would you react?
Well, if it was to be hijacked by English people, I would be very annoyed.
Probably quite fiercely, like a chilli-flavoured cocktail.
I would be totally devastated unless it was Chris Moyles.
Which celebrity would you most like to hijack Scotland?
Leona Lewis.
The Prodigy, as they are the twisted fire starters.
Olivia Newton-John.
Evel Knievel, I think he'd stand up to the task quite well. But he's dead, isn't he? William Shatner.
Can John become a Scottish folk hero like Ali McCoist or the Proclaimers?
I think he's still got quite a few things to do to get to folk hero status, but I'm sure he'll have a few things up his kilt that he'll be able to pull out the hat.
Yeah, I think John could go on to become the next William Wallace.
Should John lead Scotland?
Nah.
There we are. 40 minutes on fire and the vomit comes right out. Try that at home.
Don't. It's official, folks. The Big Brother audience prefer roller-skating misogynists to people who look pretty. This is a sad day for Britain. Thankfully, on this show, we value the thoughts of people rather than the ability to do a funny handstand.
Jade is the third best-looking woman in England. Fact. But we also know that she's intelligent. Behind Hawkins and Vorderman and Doctor Who, she's the fourth most intelligent person in England. Which is why, in this part, we're going to put that to the test. Members of the audience are going to ask Jade questions, and Simon Donald is going to decide whether Jade or the audience has given the most insightful contribution. Simon's winner will receive this labour-saving iron.
Incredible. We've called this part the Big Brother's Big Mouth Iron Man or Woman Challenge. Let's do it.
There's your clipboard, Simon.
Okay, who's got the first question? Where's Gemma? Gemma? Ah, there you are.
Hello.
Up you stand. How you doing?
Yes, I'm good, thank you.
Good stuff. Okay, Gemma, give your question to Jade.
Have you changed your opinion on anyone since you've been out of the house?
That's a tricky one. I was really a little bit, when I came out, I realised how naive I was and that there was quite a lot of people that didn't really like me in there. I thought everyone really, I got on with everyone, you know, I kind of thought everyone was really nice. So on coming out, I kind of changed my opinion a little bit of Amelia because I thought we got on really well. And looking at her, are you booing me?
Guys, it's not panic.
guys, really. So you need time. If we're going to R and do everything, it's, you know. Sorry.
Slightly of Amelia, just for the fact that she was being a little bit mean about me, and I thought she was amazing. I really respected what she did and like her talent. And I just really wanted her to teach me.
Beautiful. Yeah. Stop right there. Donald, what did you think of that answer?
Question I got, opinion. Answer I got, wah-wah-wah-wah-wah, Amelia.
Love it. So that is what you get with Donald. Where's
Jade's winning?
Malachi. There you are, baby. I'm coming up. Wait right there. Stay on your feet. Get on your feet. What's your question to Jade?
Hi, Jade. Hi. Do you think you had to play down your intelligence?
No, not at all. I didn't.
That's done. Donald, how was that?
It was a good question. It was a good answer. What can I say?
There we go.
Beautiful. Okay, where's Aaron? Aaron? There you are. Aaron, sorry, let's call the whole thing off. All right. Stand up, Aaron. Okay. Hey, give us your question.
What was that dance you did on Friday when you was coming down the stairs? Can we get a replay?
Okay, thank you very much. What was the dance?
Oh, I just heard Pussycat Dolls and had to let go because I love that song too much.
Just let go.
You just let go. Can you see a little bit of that now?
Yeah!
That's it.
Have you got
Well, me and Matt will sing it.
No.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? There it is.
Forgot about Pussycat Dolls. Guys.
Simon, how was that?
That was pretty good.
Was well. Well.
Love that.
Yep.
Where's Michael? There she is. Okay. Michael, give us your question to Jade.
John McCrick showed you a VT of Victor. Didn't you just want to slap Victor afterwards?
No. I'm not the slapping type.
But you look quite upset.
I was really upset by it because, as I said, I thought we were all right. I thought, as much as I didn't get on with him, like I didn't have as much to say to him as I did to others, I still thought we were on like good terms. And then seeing all that kind of upset me for the fact that he was really nice to my face. He was like hugging me every morning and being really friendly, so it kind of upset me. But at the same time, like I said, one of us was probably going to go, so it's quite nice to get it out and clear the air before one of us.
Beautiful answer. No. Okay, we're going to go to Gareth.
Where's Gareth?
Here she is. All right, what we got?
Jade, your talent was being a beauty queen. Were you the most attractive in the house?
Yeah. It's a good question. It deserves a good answer to be judged by Simon Donner. What we got?
I think everyone was pretty. It's a pretty good looking bunch of people, to be honest.
Gareth's quite good looking, isn't it? He's a rather nice looking.
Simon's got something to say. What we got?
I've got to say that was a poor question because he said your talent was being a beauty queen, but I believe you have other talents beyond that, which is why you're on this show. Is that
okay?
Okay,
well, let's not get into a dispute about it. Let's all calm down. Where's Mehdi?
Hi here.
Were you christened Mehdi?
Kind of.
Wow,
really, no.
Stand up. What's your question?
In the house you said that you...
So sorry, I didn't mean to stand... Wait there. What's your question?
In the house you said you'd never go topless. Has your opinion on that changed since you've come out of the house, and how much money would it take for you to do it?
What's the cash to get them out? That's the question.
I I wouldn't do it no matter how much anyone paid me. It's just not
£7 million.
No,
come on.
One out for £7 million.
Okay, what do we think on that? What do we think on that?
Predictable question, predictable but honourable answer. So I think I'm going to favour with Jade on that.
I love those words. Okay, yeah. Where's Alicia? There she is. Okay, let's make this really quick in question and answer form.
In the house, did you feel that you had to try and compete with the other girls, particularly Amelia, because it seemed like you was trying to do that?
Not at all. I thought they were all great. I really liked them. We got on really well. There wasn't any of the girls I dislike at all.
OK, thank you so much for that. That was incredible. We're going to give the iron away while you watch this bit of art critic Brian Sewell hijacking the house. Run the VT.
There's just one small thing I wanted to say to you, which I'm sure won't be broadcast. I thought you were quite your own man, quite heroic the other morning when you were awakened in the middle of having a wank and you went on with it. And I thought, good for you. There really is somebody there with some stomach. You don't...
has that been broadcast?
I think, as I've seen it, it must have been.
Oh, that's not good, is it?
It's perfect. It's perfect because the one question everybody asks about Big Brother is sex. Because you know the hormones are raging. Over and over and over again, the question arises, what do they do? And there were you, the only honest person in the team, doing it. So, congratulations.
Well, thank you, I think.
There it is, Michael's
got
it!
Well done, Michael.
That's all from us tonight. We've just got time to say a big thanks to Jade and Simon Donald.
This BBBM 2008 and our Iron Person. You lot are now in the envy of your friends. The studio audience, you had two chances to win, but failed.
We'll be back the same time tomorrow. Join Dermot at 7:30 for BBLB. Don't you dare go anywhere. It's been a great night. We'll see you tomorrow.